Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Welcome to the first service of Revival is Here Church. God put this in my heart several years ago. I've been praying for it. Elder Charles has been praying for it for a long time. There's been doors that's been open, but we didn't feel that it was right to take it. And, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. That's not stage fright, that's the Holy Ghost falling on
me. Amen.
Amen.
It's important that we flow in the Holy Spirit during the services and let Him move. And that's why I like to get the announcements done first, so we don't stop the move of the Holy Spirit. Because sometimes announcements can stop the flow.
That's right.
And I want to thank everyone for coming out. Invite people to come out. Tell them. This is not a religious service. This is a Holy Ghost service. Amen. I've told people about church, and they say, I'm not religious, and I say, I'm not either.
Amen. Amen.
And I explain to them about the kind of services that I go to and that I do, and they want to be a part of it. So go tell them. Go out in the highways and the byways, if God allows me to. I'm going to preach that during the sermon. But go out to the people that others have looked over, because they are hungry for a genuine move of the Holy Spirit, and they just want somebody to reach out to them.
Amen.
And I have this sheet. I don't know if everybody got one. Did everybody get a sheet? This is all the information of the ministry. I wanted to type it out on a sheet so it's easy to read, and you can't fit all this on a card, and it's easier to see it on the sheet. There's already a TV program on Time Warner Cable, Channel 98, Tuesdays at 7 p.m. There's a Revivals Here TV network on the Roku box. The ministry website, there's 103 podcasts so far. It's been a podcast almost every week for 2 years. Next week will be 2 years of podcast. A lot of people from around the world has been listening to them. I got a testimony from India where I mailed a DVD of the service I preached here, the first Tuesday I preached, and some prayer calls we prayed over. I mailed them to India. I got a testimony where he played them for pastors over there, and he interpreted them. Felt the Holy Spirit fall.
Hallelujah.
So God is doing a work throughout the world already through the ministry. And sometimes I feel like backing up, but God just keeps pushing me forward. And I encourage you to get into the praise and worship. And don't hold back. Don't be embarrassed. Let the Holy Spirit fall on you. There's a freedom here. We believe in a freedom. We practice it. We don't just say it. Some churches, they say that there's freedom, but there's not freedom. You can go on the property and you can feel that there's something wrong. I've been in those places. But here we have a freedom. We believe in worshiping God just like a Christ Open Door does. I'm ordained under the CGIA. Just the head of that is Yonggi Cho. He's a pastor of the largest church in the world. And he's the founder of it. I just wanted to share that. I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I don't know if you have got the donation cards. You can fill those out and we keep records of it. I just want to take care of that, share all this information before the service starts and give everybody time to get everything situated. And now I'll turn it over to the worship team. I encourage you just to praise the Lord. Over time, we iron out different things, and it's important that we just flow in the Holy Spirit.
Praise God.
We'll have Dole come up and lead us in a couple of congregations of numbers.
Me, he just said, this is just the beginning.
Praise God.
Something great. Glory, hallelujah. Woo! Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Woo! Glory, hallelujah. Let's praise Him in this place. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. God, I ask you to move tonight in the name of Jesus. God, I ask you to move in your power. Glory, hallelujah. Bring people in, God, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Woo, glory, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. It's tithe and offering time. And God put in my heart, one way to do it is to have a usher or somebody stand up front with the offering plate and you bring it forward. And that's really a biblical way, is to bring your tithe and offerings into the storehouse. And do y'all, would you rather do it that way or bring it out to the pews? Bring it up front? That's what I feel. And everybody has an envelope and a card. You make your checks payable to Revival is here.
The pipes underneath there.
Sunday.
Charles Wayne, would you like to come up front? Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I just want to thank everyone for coming out. And I want to thank Pastor Linda and Pastor Bill of Christ Open Door and everyone from Christ Open Door for letting us use their church for revivals here at church. God is going to do something powerful. He is tonight. And this is the start of something great. God put this time in my heart to have revivals here at church Sunday nights at 6:30. So everyone come out. And whew, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. God gave me some words the other night. God says that He has chosen us, Revival is here, church, to bring revival. Others have had the call but didn't come. He has chosen us. God says He will bring them in from everywhere.
Praise God. Amen. Amen.
You, everyone here, has had dreams, big ones. And God says now is the time. God says tonight He is awakening the gifts He has given to you. God is going to bring glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Woo, glory, hallelujah. God is going to bring people in.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah. When I get in the spirit, I kind of, most of the time I get where I don't know where I'm at. I get in my own little world and get in the spirit world. And some people would keep asking me if I was okay. They'd ask me, are you all right? Because I'd be lost, you know, somewhere else. I said, yes, I'm good. I'm good. Don't bother me. I'm good. I'm in the spirit. God just loving on me. And God has given me a word. God isn't going to increase the anointing upon you, and you will see it increase upon you, Betty. God is going to increase the anointing upon you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're going to see a difference.
Thank you, Jesus.
And if I get some people's names wrong, I apologize. I'm in the spirit, so. If God's going to increase it upon you, He's going to visit you. You're going to see it. He's going to come down, and He's going to visit you. And a strong power and anointing.
Praise God.
Glory, hallelujah. And it goes for ladies out here. God's going to visit some people here and He's going to bring a strong anointing and touches upon you. And He's going to send you out and bring people in. You're going to be the intercessors and God's going to use you mightily. He's going to awaken some gifts that's been dormant. Or people has pushed down, they discouraged you, they pushed the calls down inside of you. They said, you can't do this, or you can't do that, or you got to be with me, or you got to be under me. They might have discouraged you, but God is going to bring those gifts to life, that anointing to life He has placed inside that people might have got jealous about. But God is going to awaken that. And I believe in a freedom. I believe in a freedom to let people just flow with the gifts that God has placed in them and to encourage that, not to discourage that. I asked you, God, to just move tonight and have your way in the name of Jesus. I asked you, God, to just pour your spirit out in a powerful way. God, let your will be done in the name of Jesus. God, let your will be done in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, amen. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Sometimes it's good to wait on the Lord. Glory, hallelujah. Just soak God in. Just soak God in. It says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good.
Amen.
So, drink him in like you're drinking a glass of water. I know some of you might think it's silly, but you got to drink God in just like you're drinking a glass of water. You'll feel him. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I rebuke you, Satan, out of this area in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. You demon of religion, I rebuke you out of this area in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. God's given me a good sermon. He hasn't allowed me to preach tonight, but he's put it on my heart to preach. It's about curses. I know a lot of people listen to the podcast, a lot of people. I heard some good response off of the TV network from it. And God wants to break curses off of people in this area. There's been this generational curses that's been on people, and it seems like you just can't quite get that breakthrough. It's like you can't quite get that dream that you've been reaching out for. It's like every time things go good, something happens and messes it up. And it could be a generational curse that's been on your family. And sometimes alcohol can bring a generational curse. There's a big prominent family that had a curse on their life because of alcohol. There's two families, big name people, that their whole families have had like this curse on them. It's like a lot of us died young, accidents and things. It could be a curse that becomes on your life through alcohol, and that can bring the pharmakeia spirit, the curse of drugs and alcohol, like the next generation can get into drugs, and then the next generation will get worse. And it's a generational curse. There's a lot of sickness, cancer, and a lot of things because of a curse. Like there's a proven that there's a defective gene that will cause different cancers. It's a generational curse. And God has really given me that good teaching on that. And he doesn't want his children to be under a curse, because when we are born again, we are free from that curse of the law. And we need to break that curse off of us. And we need to be mindful of that in the spiritual warfare. And we need to know why things are happening, you know, why that you just can't seem to get that breakthrough. You just can't seem to get that blessing. Or it's like when things go good, it just everything falls out underneath of you. It could be a curse. It's been on the families. And sometimes the whole families have that problem that you just can't get a breakthrough. It's just thing after thing happening. And it's very important that we know these things. And God has given me some really good teachings about that, and also about wise counsel. We always hear about, you must have counsel, you must have counsel, and all these things. You always hear this, but the thing is, the Bible says wise counsel,
amen.
Not all
counsel.
Amen.
That's
right.
The key.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Because if someone has wise counsel for you, they will ask to give you that counsel. They will not force their counsel upon you. If someone says, if you don't listen to me, my counsel, your ministry is going to fall, don't listen to that. That's a Jezebel spirit.
Yep.
I've heard many people go from church to church. Come on now, I'm going to preach it to you. Go church to church.
That's right.
They say, God told me to say something to the senior pastor. If they don't listen, then the church is going to fall. That's from the devil.
Amen.
That's unwise counsel. God, give me that teaching. That's really good teaching. That's important. When someone tells you something, that you have to change this, you have to change it. If it's bothering you, don't listen to it. Mm-hmm. That's unwise counsel. Mm-hmm. Don't let that hold you back from your call. Many people get held back on that call because of that. Because people come against them. So, oh, you too loud, or you know, you too, you dance too much before the Lord, or you do this or do that. Don't listen to them. You worship God. You do the call of God is placed on you. Don't listen to that Jezebel, that grumpy spirit that people have that try to hold you back.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Because God wants you to worship Him.
Amen. Amen.
You can have a curse of barrenness on your life if you make fun of someone for worshiping God. Mm-hmm. There'll be a barrenness. David's right. wife made fun of him, and there was a barrenness that fell on her.
That's right.
And David said, I'm going to do it even more just because you come against me.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
It's good to be stubborn. It's really good to be stubborn in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
That's a gift. It said the righteous are as bold as a lion.
Amen. Take a stand.
Yes. Like David, he said, I'm going to worship God even more.
Amen.
Be determined.
Yes.
Amen.
And that Caleb anointing. We need a Caleb anointing. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take that mountain. People might try to discourage you. Say, oh, you can't do this. Oh, you too. Oh, you can't do this. You don't have an education for that. If God has placed it on you, you do it.
Amen. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Be determined. Say, I'm going to do it. I don't care whether you like it or not. Even if a pastor comes against you. You do what God has called you to do. I'm not going to come against you, and they're not going to come against you.
That's right.
But I'm just saying. But sometimes pastors can get a little jealous. Mm-hmm. We don't need jealousy in the body of Christ.
No.
Amen.
We don't need that. There's a jealousy and anger, it seems like, it's creeped in. Like it's Jezebel's spirit, and this Leviathan spirit, it's creeped into the church. God has given me good teachings on that, some really good teachings. By Jezebel and Leviathan. I preach those sometimes, but it's kind of creeped into the church where we don't allow God to move. We don't allow people to be used by God. We don't allow the prophetic to flow. Which, the prophetic, do not use the prophetic to run someone down. Do not use that. I've seen people use the prophetic. I've seen it in a service. There was a minister and someone pointed out a minister from that church was preaching, and as a visiting minister was there, and they said to this person, they didn't know this person was a minister, said they's back split and all that, they need to do this and they need to do that. Then it was so much confusion, the prophetic word, it was just so much confusion there. And that's not from God. God will not point you out directly in front of everybody and say, you backslid. And that's not from God. Dispose you like that. So I just want to point that out about prophetic. I encourage prophetic, the real prophetic. I encourage that. I love that when it's encouraging people. Because the real prophetic will encourage you. God wants to encourage His people. He doesn't want to pull them down. When the Holy Spirit convicts you, that's different. The Holy Spirit's not going to come out in this audible voice and to everyone and say, you have done this, you know. He does that. He convicts you.
Uh-huh.
And or if he does, he will do it. If he does speak through someone, it will be in private. It won't be in front of everyone. So I just wanted to share that. Because, you know, it's really good we have prophetic in the church. And this is not my sermon. But when we have prophetic in the church, there will be new life. Like it says in Ezekiel, the dry bones prophesy to those bones,
yes,
and they shall live. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot in the church today, there's a dead
yes.
dry bones in the church. And when they don't have prophecy, it's dead. I speak in tongues. I'm a proud tongue talker. I have been for a long time. And it's for every church and every denomination, everyone that's born again, get baptized in the Holy Spirit.
That's right, amen.
That's right.
Let me go into that a little bit, because we want to get some good foundations in the revivals here at church. When you get born again, like I've said before, it just gets your foot in to get you ready for the blessings. It gets you right. You are a new person, a new creature. You're not completely immersed in the Holy Spirit until you get the baptism in the Holy Spirit. That's a traditional teaching in Pentecostal church. And when you get the baptism in the Holy Spirit, it's always evidence, is always tongues. People say otherwise, but the very first time it was tongues. So that's what I'm going to preach.
Amen. That's right, brother.
But there's also, it's not really a third, but you would call it a third, but it's not really a third. It could be a third, 3 through 1,000. The times of refreshing, you get refilled in the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
A refilling. And like there was a time when they was all together worshiping God, and I believe that's after they got on them, it was going to lock them up and said, don't you preach in that name. Then they come back and they was praising the Lord. I believe it was right after that. But they was all together praising the Lord, even the apostles. And the building shook, and they was all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke in tongues. But that was a refilling for some. And some, I believe, they got baptized for the first time. Some of them got a refilling.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
But it's important to get a refilling.
Amen.
A refilling. And that really goes along with teaching the first thing that God has given me about the oil in the lamps. And I've heard someone say falsely, which I'm not against having an intimacy with God. I'm not against that. We need to have an intimacy with Jesus. We need that. But oil in the Bible represents the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Someone said that represents intimacy. That's a false teaching. That's leaving out the Holy Spirit. There's a lot of teachings that sound good, but they leave out the Holy Spirit. They try to explain away the Holy Spirit. Because that's where the power comes.
Amen.
It says you shall receive power after the Holy Spirit has come upon you.
Yep. Yes. Amen. That's what the word says.
So the devil loves teachings that leave out the Holy Spirit. When we talk about oil, it's about the Holy Spirit. I believe anointing with oil. We anoint prayer cloths. I got some king's oil. I didn't bring it tonight, but I have some king's oil. It's Exodus 30. But it leaves a stain on me, so I don't really like praying for people on the forehead or anything, because it's got cinnamon and stuff in it. But it's a symbol. When you anointing someone with oil, it's a symbol of the Holy Spirit. And in Matthew 25, is this parable of the wise and foolish virgins. I know everyone has heard this. It says, talks, glory, hallelujah, praise Jesus. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you.
That's not stage fright
No.
either.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Praise God.
Woo! Glory, hallelujah. You know, God spoke to me a long time ago, and I was a young man. This now see it come to pass. So you know what? You keep on to that dream that God has given you, that vision. Yeah. It's just now starting to come to pass. God spoke to me. He said, I'm going to move when you preach. I'm going to touch people when you preach.
Praise God.
And they give me some requirements. Is I have to get out of the way, but be able to stand and minister and not take the credit. The problem I had was about being able to stand and minister. Because when God fell on me when I was younger, I had a hard time standing. I know one time Charles Wayne House Joe had to pack me in the house because I was drunk in the Holy Ghost.
for several hours.
I was bad shape.
He was the talk of the town.
Dad didn't know what was going on.
Mom either.
I was in bad shape. Many times God has just whammied me. I mean whammy, you know what I'm talking about. I got God whammying people. I like to say whammy. I want God whammy everyone here, and don't feel a hindered either. I know one time me and my grandmother, I had been 16 because I was driving. We was at the Carrollton Family Worship Center, and God hit me, and I believe it was the same place it was before when he took me home.
No, it was at Children of the King when we carted you home.
Was it? Yeah. See, I don't remember. I was drunk with the Holy Spirit. But me and my grandmother was at the Family Worship Center, and we both got drunk in the Holy Ghost.
Oh.
And I drove back on 71, and I don't know how to get home. It's a good time in the Holy Ghost. We went to Rodney Howard Brown meeting down in Lowell, and God whammed us there. And God just really poured His Spirit. Which I love that. But I had the problem of being able to stand and minister. I said, Lord, if you hit there in the service like this, I don't know how I'm going to minister. He used to hit me. Well, I feel like it's literally like I got struck by lightning. I mean, I'm telling you, it was so intense, I thought I was going to die. I mean, I'm not just... You imagine grabbing hold of an electric fence, and it shocks you. And then God used to hit me that way. I couldn't sit still. I'd scream and holler and everything else, and be during the service, and God, He just whammed me, and just sucked service through me. And other people would feel it around me. It was a real genuine thing. And other people would feel it, and they couldn't even sit beside me.
Praise God.
And God just, He touched me. And I've seen people, I've seen this with my own eyes. One person, this was a leader in a church in Florence where God sent revival there. I used to go on Friday nights there at a river meeting. And of course, John Arnott preached there. John Gilpatrick, I've heard him preach there too. Randy Clark, I've heard him preach there. I don't think Rodney Howard Brown came, but this leader, in the palm of his hands, it would be oil, would appear in his hands. I saw it right in the palm of his hand. I literally saw it. I mean, I was sitting right beside him, I saw it happen. There's another man with gold dust would appear on him, on his skin. He couldn't wipe it off. It would appear on him when God would fall. God does different things to people. Manifest in different ways.
Amen.
I see people just, God will touch them. And you know it's God, because they know why people can do this on their own. Yeah. It's a sign and a wonder.
That's right.
He points to Jesus. Because there'd be people that don't believe that there is a God, but when they see this stuff, that they can't doubt.
Mm-hmm. That's true. That's right.
God's going to do some amazing things through this church, through revivals here. God's going to bring some people in. We're going to grow. We're going to encourage people to go out. When it really grows, they send people out to Kenya and India to have services and things. They asked me in India to come over there. Man, I've been in communication with, I don't know how you pronounce his name. It sounds like it looks like Sand Deep. It's what it looks like his name is. But I mailed a DVD of the service to him, and I shared this with you already, but he was so hungry, he just wanted us to, he didn't ask for any money, but he wanted us to send a DVD of the service so he can play at different places, and he translated it for them. And pastors in India, and they felt the Holy Spirit. And mailed a DVD and a CD to Kenya, Africa, and a little revival broke out there too. Mm-hmm. And people's getting touched.
Praise God.
And that's what it's about. It's just bringing the presence of God to them. It's about, which when you bring the presence of God, you bring in the love of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And it's about, and God put this vision, a dream in me. I haven't shared this. He told me, and in time God told me all these things, I'll be honest with you, I didn't believe them. But I knew it was from God. from God, but it was about me, so I had a hard time believing it. You know, if it's for someone else, you would say, yeah, I believe that. But he said that under me, people was going to go out all over the world. I didn't see how that would happen. But that's what God showed me. And so when you need to encourage people. And don't get jealous. I've seen pastors where they say they encourage people, but when people start flowing, they get jealous. I've seen there's a jealousy that comes in their heart, and they try to discourage you. They'll talk about you behind your back. I've seen this happen. I mean, I didn't hear about this. I saw it happen. So I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to discourage you. I want to encourage you. And bring people in. God wants to raise up a young people that's going to be so on fire for Him.
Amen.
He's going to raise them up to be a beacon of light. God's going to send a revival to Hollywood. He showed me that He was going to send revival to Hollywood. And if you go in the Roku, the area, there's a lot of people in the California Hollywood area. That whole, there's a bunch of dots around the whole area, different cities that are going to the Revivals Here TV network and Facebook page and stuff. They're looking. And I don't know anybody in Hollywood, so I haven't said, hey, look, watch this. It's just God confirming what He said. And I don't mean to keep going on and on. I just felt led to share these things about just reaching out to people. And then when it grows, we're going to try to reach out to different areas. But let's go into Matthew 25. It says, then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight a cry was heard, behold, the bridegroom is coming, go out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish ones said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise answered, saying, no, lest there shall not be enough for us and you, but go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterwards, the other virgins came also, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, surely I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming.
Amen.
That's talking about oil that represents the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You've got some that believe in the baptism of the Holy Spirit and some don't.
That's right.
And that's really goes for this day. That's right before the coming of the Son of Man. You've got a group that doesn't believe and a group that believes.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, it's for now. And I encourage you to get it. Don't feel scared to come up to this altar and pray during when I'm preaching. If you feel God tugging at you to get it, He wants to touch you. Don't be afraid. God wants to touch you. Just because I'm preaching, you know, I don't tell God He can't move when I'm preaching that I got to preach. I'm not like that. God can move anytime He wants. But it's important that we have enough. We have the baptism in the Holy Spirit that we need to get filled up. And get refilled and refilled and refilled and refilled and refilled. I like calling some meetings renewal meetings. I like that. They call them renewal meetings in the 90s. And when God broke out. And I've been to some of them. But let me tell you something. God wants to renew you and He wants to just keep filling you up. Every service, Every time, even when you're at home, alone, God wants to come down and fall on you and just shake that whole bed where you're at. He's fell on me a lot of times. I'm laying in bed. I'd feel God, he'd give me some words, and I wouldn't have a notebook beside the bed. So I go up and write it down, go lay down again, he'd give me another word. So I get up, go write it down, lay back down. You know, but God wants to come in the night and touch you.
Amen.
And let's turn to Luke 14. How about the Great Supper? This is really the Great Commission, I think. But God has invited some people to be a part of what he's doing, but they make excuses. Oh, I can't, you know, he has to come out tonight. Oh, I can't, I've been busy. He invites people, but they make excuses. I got to go to a wedding. I got to do this. I got to do that. Let me read this parable. Let's just see what God says about it. Start in 15 would be a good place. It says, now, when one of those who sat at the table, this is Luke 14, verse 15. Now, when one of those who sat at the table with him heard these things, he said to him, blessed is he who shall eat bread in the kingdom of God. Then he said to him, a certain man gave a great supper and invited many, and sent his servant at supper time to say to those who were invited, come, for all things are now ready. But they all with one accord began to make excuses. The first said to him, I have bought a piece of ground and I must go and see it. I ask you to have me excused. And the other said, I have bought 5 yoke of oxen and I'm going to test them. I ask you to have me excused. Still another said, I have married a wife, therefore I cannot come. So that servant came and reported these things to his master. Then the master of the house, being angry, said to his servants, go quickly into the streets and lanes of the city and bring in here the poor and the maimed and the lame and the blind. And the servant said, master, it is done as you commanded, and still there is room. And the master said to the servants, go out in the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in.
Amen.
That my house may be filled.
Praise God.
Amen.
For I say to you that none of those men who were invited shall taste my supper. That's what God is saying right now, what he's going to do. There was words given. Yeah. I had this sermon already written out. There was words given in the same thing. God is saying, go out. It's going to be two ways. According to this, the Bible says, first it would be the poor, maimed, and lame, and the blind. Then it says, go out again. Just go out and ask everybody. Go out and compel them to come in. Glory, hallelujah. I've been talking to people and asking them to come out. And I'm really excited. I'm glad. I want to thank God for everybody that's here. I'm really excited. But God said he's going to do a work.
Amen. Amen.
He's going to send revival.
Amen.
He's going to set the captives free.
Yes.
Jesus has come to set the captives free. Glory, hallelujah. He didn't come to put you in more bondage. He didn't come to put all these requirements on you. He's come to set the captives free. And let me tell you something. When you're free, you're going to praise the Lord. There's going to be a freedom. Amen. We had a good praise and worship time tonight. I had a good hallelujah time. Not like a good hallelujah time.
Amen.
You know what? God will come down and whammy you when you praise Him.
Amen.
Amen.
When we lift God up, He'll bring people in.
Amen.
He inhabits the praise of His people.
Amen.
God showed me this.
Amen.
It's like this. When we praise Him, it's like a vacuum. He's going to suck people in.
Amen.
Amen.
Yep.
He's going to bring the people in.
Yes.
Do not be worried about small beginnings. I don't think this is really too, this is not small to me, but I'm just saying, don't be worried about small beginnings. God is going to do a work.
Amen.
He's going to do, he's going to visit some of you. He's going to whammy you. I'm talking about just the power that's fall on you.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to be, some of you is going to rest on you. You're going to have a long time just getting used to a bell function. I had a hard time getting used to be able to function. But let God touch you.
Amen.
Amen.
Let
Amen.
Him move upon you. And let me tell you something. When God touches you like it, you're going to go out everywhere. And you're going to tell everybody about what God is doing here. Or how He's touched you. He won't have to tell you. You're just going to do it. You're excited about it. And other people, they'll feel that on you, that anointing. And God wants to love on His people. He wants to love on His bride. He wants to just completely just ravish them like it was the Song of Solomon. He wants to ravish His people. He's crazy in love with you, and He wants, God the Father wants to love on you. He wants to love on you. I believe that God is going to just keep coming down more and more and more. And we're going to see the glory cloud.
Praise God.
God's going to come down. And He come down tonight. He's here.
Yes.
That's right.
Glory, hallelujah.
Amen.
Woo.
Praise you,
Lord,
Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Yes. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I ask you, God, to move upon your people, God, with the power, God, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Woo! Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. God, come down in power. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Some of you that's really feel a very strong touch, come forward and I'll pray for you. Service is not over, but I'm not going to flow in the Holy Spirit. Some of you feel a really strong touch.
Thank you, Father.
Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you something. When God's moving, Don't sit around with a frown on your face and just let God pass you by. Let me tell you something. There was a blind man that knew who Jesus was, and he cried out, and they tried to tell him to be quiet, and he cried out louder. Let me tell you something. When God comes down, when he's here, when Jesus is passing by, don't be timid and say, I can't. Let me tell you something. You go through that crowd and you grab a hold of the hem of his garment. You hear what I'm telling you tonight? Amen. Don't be scared. Yes. Let me tell you something. I'm not going to judge you how you act. Let me tell you something. You let God come down and fall on you, and let me tell you something. You'll never be the same again. You will never get that breakthrough if you don't reach out and grab a hold of him. You hear what I'm telling you?
Amen.
Put aside that pride and put aside that old, that dead religious thoughts that you have. And just jump into that river. You hear what I'm telling you? You have no problem when you go down to the ball games and scream and holler and shout, or when you're watching the car races. And when you go down, people have no problem with showing their joy. But when they go to church, they sit there with a frown on their face. When somebody else gets excited, then they say, oh, that's not from God. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something, I'm going to be more excited about God than I'm going to be any ball game.
Amen. Amen.
I don't get in ball games anyway. We need to have a freedom and have a hunger,
yes, Jesus,
to reach out and grab a hold of what God is doing.
Yes.
Glory, hallelujah. Don't let him pass you by.
Yes,
yes,
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Yes.
If someone was handing out a bunch of money, you would sure grab a hold of it, wouldn't you?
Yes.
God's handed, he's handed out some anointings.
Amen, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
Glory,
you.
Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
Yes,
Jesus.
Come up here, sister, Cindy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Me?
Cindy. You come up front, too, if you want to. Your toes. I want to know one back.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
God wants to touch your daughter. That's what you got burdened about, ain't it?
Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
If she was here, this would be the word that I will give her. God told me to tell her. God says that don't worry about what she's done in her past.
That's right. Amen.
To seek him. He's going to use her, and God wants to tell her to don't worry about what she's done in her past, and that stuff will be behind her. Once she gets born again, it'll be behind her.
Yes.
It's going to be her, and don't listen to what people say. Don't listen to all these things that people's told her that she's not good enough. That's what's really getting her in all this mess. She's trying to fill that void. She has this problem. I don't know if she got a self-esteem problem or something, but if she likes people tell her stuff, and like she, inside, you know, it's all inside of her. Does that make sense to you?
Yes,
yes. Is her father, does she have a relationship with him? Does he, did he say bad things about her? Or?
Just a lot of things. He was in and out.
Touch your daughter, bring her in here, God, in the name of Jesus. Get on fire for you, God, in the name of Jesus. Even I'm touching her, you'll touch her daughter, God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
You pour
yes,
your spirit out upon her,
yes,
and you set her free, God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Break the generational curse that's upon her,
yes,
in the name of Jesus, and set her free from it, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Glory, hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory, hallelujah. Don't worry, somebody's behind you. Touch her, God, in the name of Jesus. Touch her, God, in the name of Jesus. Touch her, God, in the name of Jesus. She's in doing an intercession. Glory, hallelujah. You're an intercessor. You have anointing for an intercession. You're an intercessor and evangelist. That's an intercession right there. I don't know, but that's intercession.
Yes. Thank you.
Intercessions, you're not praying with your mouth. You're praying with your whole body. You're giving birth in the spirit. Glory, hallelujah. Woo, glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Bring her in there, God, in the name of Jesus. Bring her in there, God, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Fire in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Just bring God in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Fire in the name of Jesus. Fire in the name of Jesus. Fire in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Touch her, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Touch her, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Soak in the name of Jesus. Soak God in the name of Jesus. Soak God in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Woo, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. 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 More, hallelujah. More, hallelujah. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the Lord. Just relax in the Lord. Somebody behind you. Just relax in the Lord. Somebody behind you. Don't fight it. In the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Don't fight it. Don't fight it.
Glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Some people might not like all this, but you know what? God's working.
Amen. Amen. God is working. Amen.
It's about coming in church and getting changed, not feeling worse.
Amen.
And God's—he's operating. Yes. And he's—that's an intercession right there.
Amen.
You're gonna see more and more of that as time goes on.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's real intercession.
Thank you, Jesus.
Very few people have really actually felt real intercession. Jesus interceded and he dripped the blood. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Just be mindful of the Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Send a breakthrough of finances, God, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Break that curse of poverty in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. I break the curse of poverty in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Off of the whole family in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Glory,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. She's going to compel him to come in. She's going to compel him to come in. You hear what I'm telling you?
Yeah.
Let's agree that her daughter's going to compel people to come in.
Amen.
She's going to have a testimony.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah. Glory,
hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, glory, hallelujah. Glory,
hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Move, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Let it bubble up.
Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to the Lord.
Woo, thank God. Woo, Lord.
Woo.
I need it.
Great God.
Jesus.
Joy.
Joy.
Amen. Amen. Glory.
Joy. Glory. Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Energy flows through her, God, in the name of Jesus. Surge to her. Send the lightning of the Holy Ghost to fall upon her in the name of Jesus. Glory, honey. Shine behind you. Electricity in the name of Jesus. That's what I see. Electricity in the name of Jesus. Electricity. This is a vibrator, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Electricity in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
It's important to be mindful of what God is doing. And I encourage you to step in. Step in. If you're hungry, don't be worried what people think of you. And you know, David, people thought of him more. That's what it says. You read that. When she made fun of him, but everybody else thought of him more, held him in high honor.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
So, the people in the world will hold you in high honor, but his wife made fun of him. It says all his maidservants and everything.
Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's going to happen more and more and more. See, it's fluffy. Because I believe in letting God move. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. And when God touches you, don't be in a hurry. Just, if you can go down, you just let him operate on you. Let me tell you something. A lot of times, I couldn't get up if I wanted to anyway. So, you know, and it's like it's just when anointing falls on you, you get heavier. I mean, first your weight. People have a hard time even picking you up if they're trying to pick you up. This is the anointing. The glory of God just falls on you. It's at the manna. And now here's the difference. The Old Testament and the New Testament. But they had a manna on them. Elijah had, like he had this manna that fell off of him onto Elisha. Elijah had a mantle on him, fell on Elisha, fell on him. It was a mantle. It was like a garment or like his sheep or animal skin or something. I don't know. But it fell on him. It was like on him. But now we can get it in us. As Jesus said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living.
Yeah, amen.
Out of you.
Amen.
And that's the difference. So we will see more things. More things is going to happen. More and more. Power. We are a continuation of the church in the book of Acts. So what happened then can happen now even more.
Amen.
We are a continuation of that. What happened then can happen now.
That's what he said.
And tongues is audible, it's spoken out of your mouth. It's another language that you don't know that's spoken out of your mouth. Sometimes it could be another language that's on the earth now that's spoken. It could be a language that's been dead, or it's a spiritual language. It's actually spoken. I know everybody here knows that, but I just wanted to say that to clarify that some people believe that you speak in your regular language, then just the Holy Spirit's interpreting in their ears in their language. That's false. It said they actually spoke in tongues. They spoke in tongues. It came out of their mouth. And if you don't have the baptism in the Holy Spirit, we don't have to tarry anymore.
No.
They tarried for the first time, and now you can just have it, receive it. Some people might take a while because there's a lot of things that might be clogging up, you know, spiritually. And sometimes it might take a while. You might have to just keep praying and and things. And maybe there's things that God wants to take out of your life. It doesn't need to be there. But most generally, it should happen like that. And it don't, no one has to lay hands on you. But I always like to just, when you lay hands on them, they shall receive the Holy Spirit. But it doesn't have to be that way. Even in the Bible, it said Peter preached and it fell on them. And he was astonished because he was just preaching. So it's easy to get the baptism of the Holy Spirit. We make it hard, so some people can't get it because they make it hard. They're trying to deal with their minds. But you don't deal with your mind, you just accept it. Like I've told you other times when I preached at Christ Open Door, that we're really good at asking, but we have a hard time receiving.
Amen.
So go into receiving mode and receive from God. You will hear this from me throughout revivals here at church when to go into receiving mode. Go into receiving mode and receive from God. Just like this. Receive from Him. He wants to give us good gifts. And it blesses God more than it blesses us. When He gives you gifts, He loves it even more than you do getting it. That's a part of God. He's giving you part of Himself. You know, these gifts.
Yes.
When you give a gift to someone, you're giving part of yourself. And it just, when I give gifts to people, that's why I keep asking them if they like it, because it blesses me more than it blesses them. I like that. It's part of me that I've given them. Even I'm not cutting a piece off of me, but it's part of me. But like God, with these gifts, He's giving you part of Himself. Even prosperity. And I don't preach a prosperity gospel, but I'm saying, but He does want you to prosper and to be in health just as your soul prospers.
Amen.
That's right.
That's scriptural. So He wants to bless you financially and spiritually. Both. Mm-hmm. And He wants to give you these gifts of the Holy Spirit. And I encourage you to flow in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Read about the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Flow in them. Ask God for them. It's good to want them and have a hunger for them. Paul says the hunger for them. It's good to hunger the gifts and the hunger the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Hunger things from God. And have a hunger for God. And have a hunger for you. Want more. Even when God touches you, even want more and more. Glory, hallelujah. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. And have a hunger for God. It is to want more and more. More from Him. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Not having you, didn't he? He waved you, didn't he?
You got that cat eating.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. I get lost in the spirit like that. It's like, Just receive it. Just receive it. Just speak it.
Yes, it is.
Say it for a while. Just open your mouth and just hear it.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Receive you the baptism of Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. I fall out of God, give him the baptism of Holy Spirit.
Yes,
give him the baptism of Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Just let it flow out of you. Don't come out of your mind. It just comes out of you. Just let it flow out. Just let it flow out. Just start speaking in this church. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Loose his tongue, devil, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Want your forehead to hold up, okay? Receive the Holy Spirit.
Praise you, God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Touch him in the name of Jesus.
Receive,
let it flow out of you.
Receive,
let it flow out of you. Jesus, repeat after him. Do it.
In the name of Jesus.
Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
Fire, fall in the name of Jesus. Jesus, just open your mouth and feel it. You feel it, but move your mouth, but he's the Holy Spirit speaks through. I feel a fire. I feel a fire. You feel that?
Hallelujah.
Just relax. Don't fight it. Don't pray. Just have a clear mind. Just receive it. And it'll flow out of it. Just receive it. Just don't fight it. Just receive it. Fire in the name of Jesus. Baptize my Holy Spirit and fire in the name of Jesus. 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 Don't fight it. Don't fight it. Don't fight it. Fire in the name of Jesus. Ah, Lord.
Jesus.
I feel like fire, but I felt. Do you feel that? Or hallelujah. Anybody wants a touch from God? You want a touch? You want more from God? You want a healing? Or you want to stand in for somebody? You want the baptism of the Holy Spirit? You get baptism of fire, I believe. Or hallelujah. You need a touch. Don't be scared. Come up front. Don't be scared. Just come up front. Or hallelujah. I know there's people out here who want prayer. I know there's some people. Even if you got prayer before, it's okay to be greedy when it comes to getting a touch. It's good to be hungry, doesn't it?
Amen.
Or hallelujah.
Touching
the Lord. Just rest.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You might need to touch them lower. You want to touch, go forward. Come while the water is stirring.
Glory, hallelujah.
Praise God.
And you come while the water is stirring. Glory, hallelujah. Sister Rainey, you want some more? I believe God's touched you back here. Lord, hallelujah. Lord, hallelujah. God's filling people up. He's filling them up. They're going to go out and compel them to come in. Glory, hallelujah. Whew. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. And that's the type, God's going to bring some people in here. He's going to operate on them. And he's going to bring people of all kinds. He's going to bring them in. And they're going to get a touch from him.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah. And we're going to have to see, by getting a bigger building, God's just going to bring them in. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Yes.
Praise God.
Yes. Not ready to walk.
Bless him, Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Bless our Lord.
Oh, thank you, sweet Jesus, Father. Thank you,
Jesus. Touch him today, Jesus.
Thank you, sweet Jesus, Father. Thank you, sweet Jesus.
Thank you.
Bless him, sweet Jesus.
Bless him, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
New wine of the Holy Ghost. Lord, hallelujah.
Amen.
New wine of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Whew, glory, hallelujah.
Praise God.
Glory, hallelujah. Been a good time in the Lord, hasn't it?
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen.
It's been a good time in the Lord. Glory, hallelujah. God's moved. I pray that everybody keeps coming back and just bring more people, invite more people, and just keep coming back. And God, I just touch you. Be here every Sunday night at 6:30. And if you want church to go to Sunday mornings, you go to revivals here. Christ Open Door Church Sunday mornings at 11. Same here at this location. I want to thank him for letting us use this building.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I just want to thank everyone, and I pray that God touches you. And just send a blessing. God just wants to send you blessing.
Praise God.
And you have a good week. I pray that God, Father God, I ask you. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Father God, I ask you to touch them. They will have a good week. And we'll bring other people in to church next Sunday night, God. I ask you, God, that you will touch them. They will have a prosperous week. They will get raises this week in the name of Jesus. Unexpected money this week in the name of Jesus. in the mail. The money that's been owed to them will come in. God, in the name of Jesus, you will heal them. And they will get promotions this week, God, in the name of Jesus. You will protect them, God, in everything they do. God, everything they touch, it will prosper, God, in the name of Jesus, and be blessed, God. And their family members, bless them, God, and get them to come in, God, in the name of Jesus. And use them and break those generational curses that's upon them and their family, God, in the name of Jesus. Let that hunger to can just grow, God, inside of them for you, God, in the name of Jesus. Fill their lamps with the oil of the Holy Ghost, God, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And to get them to go out and to compel them to come in, God, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Bless them, God, in everything that they do, God. Touch them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Touch them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. More, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, everyone, for coming out to the revivals here at church. I'm excited about what God is doing. I'm really excited. I'm so thankful that it's finally here. And we'll be up. Audio of it will be up next week's podcast. The video will be up on the Revivals Here TV network. Thank you, everyone, for coming out. You are dismissed. If you need to talk to me or need prayer, let me know. I'm Pastor Chan Smith, the senior pastor of Revivals Here Church. Revivals Here. Thank you. God bless.